What is up, super fam? I am Sensei Finito, and this is Battery CEO. Welcome to Marvel Bros, where we discuss all things Marvel and everything pop culture. But today, what is on the agenda for the super fam?
Well, we have something pretty cool. I was not expecting this, but we have Netflix's Cyberpunk Edgerunners official teaser trailer.
What?
I didn't even know we were getting a Cyberpunk
type project. Literally.
Netflix. Did you play the game?
No, I did not play the game Cyberpunk. No, I
have the game.
I wanted to play it, literally, but never played it. I know that there was just like everyone was like, no, this is not it. So I just never bought it. And then when I bought my PC, I just never even thought about getting it because I knew there were still issues
a lot of issues.
Yeah.
I was given the special edition for my birthday, and ever since it's still in the wrapping. I've never even opened it.
Damn, not still in the wrapping. I remember they did like a mass callback and like a massive recall as well. Like it was crazy. I think that was like one of the worst game launches and like anything in like history of video.
It was pretty bad. It was pretty foul of them to even go forward with it. Especially being like the Red CD Project people, you know, they're just like, yo, they're just like, why? You guys have done beautiful games in the past. How are you guys going to throw it out the window because of a deadline? You know, just push it back. There's nothing wrong. Obviously, you've been pushing it back for 15 years.
I was about to say, okay. I think it's been pushed back. I think they just didn't want to push it back into oblivion. I think if they make a new one now, it'll be really good. Because the thing is, when you're like, to me, if you're working on a game for 15 years, bro, you're going to have a bad time because the graphics between PS4 and PS5 and just the technology that has come out in that short time as well. Well, it's not really a short time because it was low-key a little bit, you know, time between the Xboxes and the new generation that we're at now. But still, it's like it's a massive jump. That's why they're having so many problems with a lot of games like that are both compatible, or if the developers are like, nah, bro, we're just making new gen stuff from here on out because the other stuff can't even touch what we're doing. But I'm interested in seeing what this is. And this is our, like, what else is there that Netflix has? Dota, Arcane, you know, like Netflix has quite a few animes that are connected to video games. So it'll be interesting to see how this one is hitting.
Yeah, I'm ready to check this out, man. I have no idea what this could be. Let's check it out.
Oh. Oh. Wait a minute.
Oh my. I'm getting some Cowboy Bebop vibes.
Wait a minute. This has potential.
Oh my god.
Yo!
Oh my god! Yo! Oh, dude. Oh my god.
Whoa!
I've never felt more called to something.
September.
In a long time. Yo. That looked incredible. Was... Yo,
bro,
animation.
I was already
crazy,
sold
bro.
Before it went like, okay, hardcore. This is wrong. Yeah, like exactly. Like I was already sold on it. I was like, yeah, this is awesome. And then the next shot, you see the dude get literally blown up. Like this is going to be amazing. I think this is going to be awesome. I really don't know what this is going to be about. This was a teaser, of course. Mm-hmm. Let me see if there's a blurb. How are you feeling, bro?
I think this is going to look incredible. You know, Netflix does a really good job with their animations that they come out with. Right now, I'm watching Vampires in the Garden.
I did a
reaction
solid.
To that.
Yeah, that's a really good one.
I'm loving it so far. I haven't finished it yet, but I'm loving every bit of it. Dota was awesome on Netflix.
I haven't seen Dota yet.
That one was amazing. There's another one I've been watching that I have watched on Netflix as well. I just can't think of the name. But they do a really good job with animes. And there's also like a Roman. There's one I want to watch that I haven't checked it out. But I guess it's like a Roman architect who like designed stuff for the Emperor.
What? Yeah.
He does like bathrooms or like stuff like that, and he like falls into somewhere and he like gets teleported into like the modern times, and like he's like looking at architecture of bathrooms, of like modern bathrooms, and all of a sudden he finds himself in Japan in the old days and saw how they did things, and he's like, oh my god, the architecture, and
that and sounds him. Awesome.
And then he takes I'm assuming he takes all that knowledge back and designs the stuff that he does for the Emperor, and it seemed pretty funny.
That sounds awesome. But this, yo, it definitely looks good. It did like a very subtle way of like introducing us to characters, I guess you could say. Like, we're like, from this little trailer, we know like at least three people that we could probably see throughout
regularly.
And I think the aesthetic of everything really like encapsulated what cyberpunk is. You know what I mean? Like, it felt like we were in like a cyberpunk type of a city in the first place. So I'm hoping that this hits the way that I think it's gonna hit because it looks like this is gonna be a definite banger pop.
It looks like
possibilities.
It looks like it's going to be as good, if not potentially better, than what we got with Arcane.
Yeah, because that had some deep.
I think a lot of people who watched Arcane were like, yo, this is next level animation, next level storytelling. And if we
get next level music, let's not forget that. Like, yeah, the music in that show was crazy.
I think not only the community saw that, but I think Netflix saw that. And they were like, you know what? We got to do more of this. And I think they thought ahead already, because I'm sure this has been in development since before Arcane was even out or prior to that, you know? So I'm sure now that they've seen the response for Arcane and the obviously the game was super anticipated, so it's going to probably be big regardless. But I think the world that this can set up is going to be pretty incredible.
Yeah, I agree. Netflix and then we do understand that Netflix doesn't make these, they just like buy the rights to them. So don't come for us in the comments when we talk about like Netflix is doing their thing. But Netflix is doing their thing because there's not a lot of other streaming platforms that are constantly pumping out original anime content the way that Netflix is.
Yeah.
They are giving a lot of these like places like the opportunity to even put out there, you know what I mean? Like, I don't think as much people would have watched Arcane if it was on like Paramount Plus, what I mean? Or even Amazon Prime. Like, I don't think it would have been the same. I don't think it would have been the same type of takeover that it was. Mm-hmm. Like, everything about that show, like you were saying earlier, everything that show hit, like the music, the animation, the voice actor, like everything hit perfectly with that. And it does seem like Cyberpunk Edgerunners has all of those ingredients.
All those ingredients and potentially even more.
Amazing. Yeah. Yeah, that's true. Because they're definitely capitalizing on that adult, like X-rated stuff. Like, you could tell. Mm-hmm. And that's already what Cyberpunk is as well, as we've been talking about. So you know they're going to push some boundaries here.
Oh, yes. But I'm excited to check this out, though.
Yeah, I agree, bro. And if you guys didn't know, memberships are now active on the channel. And by becoming a member of the channel, you have access to member-only badges, channel emojis, and other special perks. Everything that you do with becoming a member helps us in what we do here at Marvel Bros. And we appreciate all the love and support that you guys give.
Oh, yes. And if you haven't already, please make sure to follow us on all of our social medias at Marvel Bros. On our Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Twitch, and our YouTube channel. Plus all of our content, much more.
That is right. Thank you for tuning in with us on another awesome trailer reaction and an episode of Marvel Bros. And we hope to see you guys on the next one.
Oh, yes.
Excelsior.
Peace. To support Marvel Bros, all you gotta do is visit our website at www.marvelbros.com and buy some merch. Represent the superfan.
Or you can join our Patreon to get early access to content, patron-only scoops, giveaways, private Q&As, and those sacred watch parties.
We appreciate you guys. We'll catch you on the next one.
Excelsior.
On today's Pop Culture News Update.
And on today's Pop Culture News Update.
On today's Pop Culture News Update.